In this video, we are going to solve a problem using Mason's gain formula. So first of all, what is Mason's gain formula? It is used to find transfer function of a system. What is transfer function? Output by input. Output by input. According to Mason's gain formula, transfer function is sum of k, pk, delta k, all divided by delta. I will explain each and everything part by part. So the first step in Mason's gain formula is to find the number of forward path. That is our k value. So what do you mean by forward path? In how many ways we can reach from input to output? So this is one straight way. This is the first way. Then the second way. From here, the graph, it can go like this and reach the output. That is our second method. Now third method. Can we go like this? No. Here the arrow direction is opposite to our direction. So we can't go through this way. Then the next way. After reaching here, can you go like this? No. After reaching here, the arrow mark direction is opposite to our direction. So we can't use this way and this way. So this is our first path, the way by which we can reach from input to output. So this is our first path. So P1. P1 is the product of all these gains. 1 multiplied by G1, G2, G3, G4, G5. So first path it will be G1, G2, G3, G4 and G5. Now the second path. From here, starting from here, after reaching here, the graph can go like this. Here the arrow direction is same as our direction. So this is the second path. So for our second path, the product will be 1, G6, G4, G5 and 1. So path 2, the gain are 1 multiplied by G6, G4 and G5. We can write that in order, 4, 5 and 6. So after rewriting it as G4, G5 and G6. So these are our two paths. There are two paths. So k value will be equal to 2. If k value is 2, then transfer function will be sum of p1 delta 1 plus p2 delta 2 all divided by delta. If k value is 3, then there will be p3 delta 3. If k value is 4, then there will be p4 delta 4, like that. So in this question, k value is 2. So p1 delta 1 plus p2 delta 2 divided by delta. We already found p1 and p2. Now we need to find delta 1, delta 2 and delta. In step number 2, we need to find individual loop gain. What do you mean by individual loop gain? Find the number of loops in this system. As you can see here, G2 minus H1, it is a loop. Now, G2, G3 and minus H2, it is a loop. Now here, G5 minus H3, it is another loop. Now look at here, G1, G2, G3 and G6. Can we write that as a loop? No, because G1, G2, G3, the direction is going like this. Now here it is opposite to our direction. We need the direction to go like this. But here it is of opposite direction. So we can't take this one as a loop. In this question there are three individual loops. So loop gains are for loop 1, the gain it will be G2 multiplied by minus H1. So G2 multiplied by minus H1, we can write that as minus G2 H1. Now loop 2, this is our second loop. Loop 2, we can write G2, G3, minus H2. That means minus G2, G3, H2. Now loop 3, third loop it is G5 and minus H3. So we can write minus G5, H3. So these are our three loops. In step 3, we need to find gain of non-touching loops. This is our first loop, this is our second loop, and this is our third loop, okay? If you're taking first loop, then first loop is not touching the third loop. Its node is not touching the third loop. But if I'm taking the first loop, then the second loop is touching first loop node. So these two loops are touching each other. But we need gain of non-touching loops. So if I'm taking the first loop, then this loop is not touching the third loop. So we can write the gain first loop and third loop. Okay, so I'm writing L13. L13 I can write as minus G2 H1 multiplied by minus G5 H3. So minus and minus it will become plus. So it will become G2 H1, then G5 H3. If I am writing it in that order, then G2, G5, G2, both G I write first, then H I write second. So this is the order. Now if I take the second loop is touching with the first loop, but second loop is not touching with the third loop. Then I can write the gain of those two loops. Second loop gain it is minus G2, G3, H2 multiplied by third loop gain. So both sides there are minus, so it will become plus. So second loop and third loop. So I'm going to write it as L23. The product are G2, G3, H2 multiplied by G5, H3. G5, H3. Now if I'm writing that in an order, G2, G3, G5, then H2, H3. So this will be my non-touching loop gain. I found the forward paths. There are two forward paths. I found the individual loops, that is loop 1, loop 2, loop 3. Then I found non-touching loops. There are two non-touching loops. Now in step 4, we need to find delta and delta k. Our delta and delta k. Now for finding delta, the denominator delta, the equation is like this. 1 minus sum of individual loop gain. We need to add all these loop gains. Plus alternate minus and plus a. Minus, plus, minus, like that. Okay. So 1 minus sum of individual loop gains. Then plus sum of gain product of non-touching loops. Two non-touching loops. Here, these two loops are not touching each other. So we need to write the gain. Already we wrote the gain products. We need to write that as in a sum form. Okay, then again alternate minus n, then sum of gain product of three non-touching loops. If there are one more loop here and those three loops are not touching each other, then that case. Generally, such a complicated question will not come for your exam. We don't want to use this equation because only up to this much we will need. In this question, there are no three non-touching loops. Okay. So we need an equation up to this much. Now, writing this equation, 1 minus sum of individual loop gains. We need to add all the sums. First one minus g2 h1 plus here minus x. So plus and minus it will become minus. So minus g2 g3 h2 plus here there is minus. So plus and minus it will become minus g5 h3 plus. Then sum of gain product of two non-touching loop. We already written in the gain product format. We need to add them. That is g2 g5 h1 h3 plus g2 g3 g5 h2 and h3. Now open this bracket, then minus and minus it will become plus. 1 plus g2 h1, then minus and minus again become plus. g2 g3 h2, minus and minus become plus. g5 h3, then open this bracket. So this is our final delta value, that is our denominator delta value. So we found p value and delta value. But now we need to find delta k. K is already we found k equal to 2. That means there are two forward paths. Okay, so first of all, we are going to find delta 1. We need to find delta 1 and delta 2. First of all, we are going to find delta 1. For finding delta 1, take the first path, that is P1. So this is my first forward path. And these are my three individual loops. As you can see here, all these loops are touching this forward path. In that case, we will write delta 1 as 1. If all loops are touching the forward path, we will write delta 1 as 1. What will happen if any one of the loop is not touching the forward path? I will tell you. Now we can find delta 2. For finding delta 2, we need to take the second forward path. That is g4, g5, g6. Now this is my second forward path. This is my second forward path. Now I am going to draw the loops. Now I am going to find delta 2. If all loops are touching my forward path, then delta 2 will be 1. Now as you can see here, third loop is touching my forward path. Second loop is also touching my forward path, but the first loop is not touching my forward path. My forward path is this one, but this loop, it is not touching anywhere. Now if any loop is not touching the forward path, then we need to write 1 minus the gain of that loop. The gain of that loop, it is, this is loop one gain, it is minus g2 h1, minus g2 h1. Now opening the bracket, we will get minus and minus, it will become plus. 1 plus g2 h1. So this is our delta 2 value. Thus we got all the values. Now our transfer function, it is k, sum of k, pk, delta k. That means here k value is 2. So sum of p1 delta 1 plus p2 delta 2 divided by delta. What is p1? p1 is our gain. That is g1, g2, g3, g4 and g5. It is multiplied by delta 1. Delta 1 it is 1. So multiplied by 1. Okay. Plus p2. p2 is our second forward path. That is g4, g5, g6 multiplied by delta 2. Delta 2 it is 1 plus g2 h1, 1 plus g2 h1. So that is our p2, p2 delta 2, now divided by delta. Delta value is this one. Now open this bracket, multiply this with 1 and this with g2 h1. So this is our final answer.